this is how they treat their new releases here at Walmart. Just get them out of the box. They just sit them on the ground. That's how it works at Walmart.
What is up, everybody, and welcome back to the Mid-Level Media Channel, your hub for everything physical media and entertainment. I am Ken, here today for another Tuesday Blues Day Blu-ray trip, and that is right, guys, we are right outside of a Walmart. Can y'all see that? Can you see the Walmart, the W right there? Yeah, what better way to start our Blu-ray hunting journey than at Walmart? And it is a huge, huge release day today, guys. We got a Clockwork Orange on 4K, although I've been hearing rumblings that we're not going to find any of that in stores today, but I don't know. We'll see. Fingers crossed. We're also getting Unbreakable on 4K. We're getting Cruella and Fast 9 with tons of in-store exclusives, Blu-rays, 4Ks, Target Editions, Steelbooks, the full deal with those two movies. And yeah, we've got a Vestron title coming out today, Dimension 13. Hopefully we can find that in stores. Tons of great, awesome stuff, guys, coming out in stores today. Loving Basketball. Maybe we'll hit up a Barnes & Noble and see if we can find that. But yeah, I am starting at Walmart. Hopefully they will have some stuff in stock. And maybe they'll have some of those kooky, weird, obscure Walmart titles. Let's check it out.
Oh yeah, guys, we are back again at Walmart, and the Hillbilly Hunter has arrived. That's right, kids, let me take the lead today. We are starting at Walmart, and this is a different Walmart. This is Walmart I'm not too used to. Are we gonna find a Unbreakable Clockworks, or maybe some Cruellas, and them guys with Vin Diesel driving the cars and stuff like that? I don't know. Maybe we'll find a VHS of Friday the 13th. I don't know. Let's see what they got.
All right, guys. So this is a Walmart that I don't usually frequent, so I have no idea if they're going to have what I need today. But hopefully they have something. I don't know. Let's see. What are these? These are kind of cool. They got Palpatine and Maul masks. So it looks like they are carrying the DVD of Cruella for 1996 and the double pack DVD as well, with 101 Dalmatians and Cruella, but nothing else new I am seeing today. They do have the spots for Fast 9 up here and the little poster, but yeah, a 9 movie collection as well, exclusive. I did not know we were getting that, and they haven't put it out yet, but I'm actually seeing the Cruella exclusive for Walmart right here on the ground, and some Fast and Furious movies as well. Assuming some of the obscure Walmart titles, we have Synapse. I don't think I've seen that before on Blu-ray and DVD. Shimmer on Blu-ray and DVD as well. We have The Legend of Gobi, The Boss Baby, seasons 1 and 2. We have Shadowland, the Blu-ray and DVD of that. So it's been a while since we've gotten these Blu-ray DVD combo sets. And they're all in the cases, but they do have Coraline and the Box Trolls. I'm still not seeing Paranorman. I kind of wanted to get that one, but I haven't seen it anywhere yet. This is how they treat their new releases here at Walmart. Just get them out of the box, and they just sit them on the ground. That's how it works at Walmart. All right. And rummage around in the Blu-ray DVD bin for a bit. Angels and Demons. How to Be a Latin Lover. So yeah, they got Blu-rays and DVDs in there. It looks like mostly DVDs. You got a 3-pack, Laugh Out Loud, The Commuter. We got Patriots Day, Now You See Me 1 and 2, Richard Jewell. We got a Rush Hour 3 film collection. That's a pretty good deal if it's only like $5. Halloween section over here, but we do have some of these new Saw covers that I haven't seen. This is a cool one for part 3. 4, 5, 6, 7. Those are all new covers. They're not slip covers. They're just regular DVD covers, but it's pretty cool. The shitty Walmart, they still have copies of the Snyder Cut on 4K.
All right, so that's like the second or third time I've been to that Walmart, and that Walmart, honestly, it gives me the heebie-jeebies. I don't like it. I don't like going in that Walmart, especially now seeing how they treat their physical media. Just stacking it all over the floor like that? How are you going to do that, Walmart? What is going on, Walmart? God, Walmart just, they just run right through me. I don't know what it is about Walmart lately, but they've really just gone downhill. So right now, guys, I'm going to head to Best Buy. Glad I got that out of the way. And now I can just be horribly disappointed when I get to Best Buy and I look for a Clockwork Orange on 4K and they don't have it, but hopefully they do. Let's see. Guys, I'm almost here. It's right behind the Wendy's. Oh God, so close yet so far away. Ooh, free nugs.
All right, guys, there you go. There's that big, beautiful beast right there, Best Buy. But I gotta be honest with everybody, I'm like sick to my stomach right now thinking about what I probably won't find in stores today. But I swear to the physical media gods, if you just get me out of this, I promise I'll pre-order from now on.
So I am seeing Cruella right here on 4K for $29.99 and the DVD for $19.99. Vertigo, Rear Window, all the usual suspects, but no A Clockwork Orange and no Unbreakable. This end cap right here, we do have Fast 9, the 4K for $29.99, the Blu-ray for $24.99, and the same thing down here, not seeing a steelbook for that either. Alright guys, so it looks like today Best Buy could not be bothered to stock any of the new releases. I am seeing a copy of the Star Trek, the original motion picture, 4-movie collection on 4K. Cool, but still no Clockwork Orange and still no Unbreakable. So I guess I'm gonna have to ask. But thank God they've got the season 4 of Hot in Cleveland on DVD. What the fuck, Best Buy?
Alright guys, so just getting out of the Best Buy, and this is just getting more and more disappointing every single week. They didn't have any of their exclusives in there. None of the steelbooks for Unbreakable, Cruella, Fast 9, none of that stuff. They still had stuff in the back that I had to get them to pull out, but I did get some of the new releases this week, but I did not get A Clockwork Orange. And, you know, he kind of broke it down for me, explained it to me. He said, you know, this is an older movie. It's in high demand. A lot of people have been waiting for this, and they just aren't giving us the quantities here that they used to. So he kind of blamed the studios for it when he was explaining it to me. He said they're just not giving us the copies that they used to. So this may not be Best Buy's fault. So let's go ahead and show you guys what I did pick up. I got Unbreakable on 4K, so I was happy to get this one at least because this was one of the ones that I really wanted. It wasn't the top of my list. The Clockwork Orange was the top of my list, but I'm excited that I at least got this. They didn't have any of the steelbooks left. They were completely sold out of those, so couldn't get that. And then I got Dementia 13, which was $12 here. So this is usually, these Vestron titles are usually at Walmart, but they were at Best Buy this time. So I don't know why they just keep switching things up on me. But yeah, Vestron, Dementia 13, Director's Cut, Francis Ford Coppola's first film. I was excited to get this one. It's a really cool looking movie. I love the colors on this cover. It's just one of the coolest covers, I think, that's come out all year. Probably one of the coolest Vestron covers, if I'm being honest. So yeah, got those two pickups. I'm excited that I have them, but again, very disappointed about Clockwork Orange. There is another Best Buy on the other side of town. I still haven't 100% made up my mind if I'm going to chance it and try the other Best Buy or not. Before I might do that, let's go to Target and see what they got for us.
Fast, guys. I've got one surprise location that I want to take you all to before we go to Target. And it's Dollar Tree. That's right, guys. The Dollar DVDs and Blu-rays are about... I'm just joking. I'm not going to Dollar Tree. I'm going to Spirit Halloween. Let's do it, guys. Let's get spooky. Oh, my God. What is this? We're going to walk through the chains. I'm going to walk through the chains. Ah! It's a cool little Pennywise cup. Should I get this? What is that? $14.99? I don't know about that, guys. Ooh, Exorcist tumbler. That's actually pretty cool. I like this. I like that. $9.99. That's a little bit more my speed. We also got Halloween 2. What is this? Some kind of goblets or something? Ooh, nice. Any questions? These guys. What's up, guys? How's it hanging? I do like this weird, funky scarecrow. Is that the bride of Scarecrow? Over there? I don't know. Could you imagine being sent to Human Resources and the Crypt Keeper was waiting there for you?
Hello, kiddies. I'm gonna help you set up your 401k.
Do I dare get the grumpy baby mask? What is that? God, Bride of Chucky Chucky is the worst. Of course, every Halloween store has to have their entire section of Nightmare Before Christmas memorabilia.
Alright guys, sorry I had to make a stop at Spirit Halloween because I'm never out in this location usually. I went to another Best Buy that I don't usually go to. And the Spirit Halloween is like right in the same shopping center. So I had to make a trip to Spirit Halloween. I've already made one before. I got the Halloween Michael Myers mask from Halloween Kills. But the store wasn't really that stocked. I think they had just opened up. So I wanted to see if I could find some of the other stuff that some other people have been finding in there that I thought was pretty cool. So the first thing I got, I'm pretty excited about. This is a really cool shirt, and I'm trying to build up my horror t-shirt collection. Can't find those cool ones at Walmart. So I got this Creepshow t-shirt. I don't know if you guys can see it. It's hard to hold the phone in that. But yeah, it's just the classic like Creepshow cover right there, which is really cool. I love Creepshow. It's one of my favorite 80s horror movies. So yeah, I'm happy to have a shirt now of Creepshow. And this other thing I got, which is pretty cool, I showed it off in the video. It's an Exorcist tumbler. And yeah, this is awesome. See, you'll probably see me sipping on this while I'm doing live streams and stuff. Maybe some water, maybe something healthy. I'll be drinking out of this demonically possessed cup. Or maybe I'll be sipping like pea soup or something out of it. I don't know. It's an Exorcist tumbler. I love The Exorcist. It's my favorite horror movie of all time. Let's get into this next one. This is really cool. And you'll probably see me sipping out of this one too, maybe on a morning live stream. But this is a movie I didn't love when I first saw it, but I've come around on it. Now it's one of my Halloween favorites. I like to watch it every year. And that is Trick or Treat. I got this Trick or Treat mug. It's a little bit bigger than the mugs that I'm used to drinking out of. I usually don't like drinking out of mugs this big. It's a pretty good size mug. But it's got Sam on it right there. A nice little image of him, which is really cool. And then Trick or Treat. I like this mug a lot. I thought it was super cool. It's orange on the inside. And yeah, that was a cool trip to Spirit Halloween. I think I got all of that. The two cups were $10 and the shirt was like $20. So I got all that for like $40. Not a bad deal at all. Not a bad deal at all. They had some other cool stuff in there, but you know, I wasn't looking to spend a lot. But yeah, let's go ahead and head to Target and hopefully they've got some exclusives. Maybe Cruella exclusive. Maybe I'll buy Cruella because I didn't get a Clockwork Orange. Feels like a good trade, right? No, not really, but let's do it.
Alright guys, so I don't know if we're going to find any exclusives in here today. I do kind of want that Target exclusive Cruella. I like the movie. It's a cool exclusive. I might get it, but if they don't have anything, my wife did text me and tell me that we needed paper plates and toilet paper. So if anything, this trip will not be a total loss. Let's see what they got. So up here at the front, I am seeing this Fast 9 exclusive Target Blu-ray. This is not a 4K. Looks pretty cool, but like I said, I'm not interested in picking up Fast 9. Not seeing any exclusives for Cruella, just seeing the DVD, so let's check back in the regular section. Alright, so I am seeing this Target's Cruella exclusive right here. It does look nice. It does look nice. I do like it, but it seems like that same exclusive that we've been seeing, the same one that Black Widow had last week. All right, let's see. They do have the Lady in the Manor here today. So that's a new release that none of the other stores had. With Judy Greer, I talked about it yesterday. They got more of these Blu-ray exclusives of Fast 9. Let's see, Black Widow on Blu-ray. They got more Boss Babies down here. They do have Batwoman Season 2 on DVD, but no Blu-ray for that one. They did have the Cruella 101 Dalmatians Blu-ray, not just the DVD that Walmart had. The note on this Cruella 4K, guys, is the actual case on the 4K is red. You don't usually see that on 4K releases, so that's actually kind of different. It's usually always black. The sale on Tom and Jerry on Blu-ray, guys, $17.99. Oh boy. Bit of a Halloween section over here with Hocus Pocus on Blu-ray for $9. Nightmare Before Christmas for $10. Let's see, they got The Great Pumpkin for $9.99, but that's a DVD. I don't know if I want to buy the DVD of that. Maybe they had a Blu-ray. Frankenweenie, I do kind of want that. $10, I don't know though. Actually looks like they have the Unbreakable 4K here, guys. The Unbreakable 4K for $25.49, so that's a full like $3 more here than it was at Best Buy. They got Speed, Space Jam, Shawshank Redemption. If only they had Clockwork Orange. Well, guys, check your local Targets because they actually have Hocus Pocus on 4K for $15. Not a bad deal at all.
All right, guys, so just got out of the Target, and you know, Target had some stuff. They had the Unbreakable on 4K, they had Cruella, the exclusives, they had Fast and the Furious and its exclusives. I'd say all around Target kind of won this week with the physical media, because they had the stuff on the shelves and they had the exclusives, which is more than I can say for Walmart, which just laid them all over the floor, and then Best Buy, which didn't have any of their exclusives at all. So all in all, this was an okay day. It was an okay day, but the main thing that I wanted was the Clockwork Orange on 4K, so it kind of feels like I lost today. It kind of feels like a really shitty Blu-ray hunt, when in all actuality, it wasn't too bad. I did get to see a lot of things in stores this week, so not too bad, but let me show you all what I grabbed in Target, besides paper plates and toilet paper. I went ahead and I didn't get the Cruella exclusive. I didn't get it. I wanted to, but to be honest, if I would have got it, I wouldn't have got it if a Clockwork Orange was there, and I got a Clockwork Orange. I would have just been picking it up to get another big exclusive pickup this week, and I didn't want to do that. I didn't just want to pick it up just because I didn't really want it. So let me show y'all what I actually got. I got Rush Hour Trilogy on Blu-ray. This was in there for $13. I thought that was a pretty good deal. So I haven't owned these since DVD. So yeah, I'm excited to rewatch these again, and I've never seen the third one. I've only seen the first and second. I love both of those. Yeah, the Rush Hour Trilogy, it's really cool artwork on here. It's like Mondo exclusive artwork. So yeah, it's a cool little set for $13. So I thought that was a pretty decent deal. But with that, guys, that does it for this week's Blu-ray hunt. Sorry about getting it out so late. This is probably going to end up going up around 7 o'clock. Tonight, but I did have to work today, which I don't usually have to do, so I didn't get out until later, which put me in an even worse position to seeing all the in-store exclusives, but that's okay. It's okay. I will live to see another Blues Day Tuesday. It's fine. I got some cool pickups. I got a cool trick-or-treat mug from Spirit Halloween. I got an Exorcist tumbler. I got a Creepshow t-shirt. I got some cool stuff today. I'm just very disappointed about the Clockwork Orange 4K, but I'm going to get on Amazon right now. I'm not going to go to Best Buy, the other one, and check it out. It's way too far away, and they probably don't have it either, so I'm not going to bother. I'm just going to order it on Amazon. Hopefully, I'll get it next week, and I can get a review out then, because, damn it, I really wanted to watch that tonight. But, all right, guys, let's go ahead and close out the video. I appreciate you guys watching. Please like, comment down below what you picked up this week. Did you find a Clockwork Orange in your Best Buy? I know that some people did. Did you find the Steelbook? I know almost nobody did, but still, I saw some people that did. Let me know in that comment section below. Let me know how this week stacked up for you. Also, be sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Turn on those bell notifications for all of those future videos, and we'll see you next time. We'll be right back.